My entrepreneurial proposal is real food. A sit-down or to-go style restaurant that majors in providing health-conscious people with delicious, healthy, and real food. We will serve mainly soups, salads, and sandwiches, perfect to stay and eat with friends or to take on the go for busier days. Most of our food will be provided by local farmers who employ organic, non-GMO, and non-pesticide methods. Currently in Knoxville, Tennessee, the market for a quick, healthy, and affordable restaurant is dry. The organic awareness is much more prevalent in California, but there certainly is an awareness in certain parts of Knoxville. Although there are a few markets and grocery stores that also provide organic, ready-made food, there is not a restaurant meeting the needs of health-conscious consumers. I want to open real food in downtown Knoxville's Market Square. Because it's more of an urban setting, I think more people will appreciate having that organic option. In addition to that, the University of Tennessee is quite near to Market Square, which will create a lot of college-age traffic. Closest alternatives to real food are Panera Bread and the local markets and grocery stores in the greater Knoxville area. Panera Bread has a wide selection of healthy foods that taste good, and they have roughly 1,800 locations in the United States. They have the upper hand because they are so well known. However, I plan to set myself apart from them by also having a gluten-free menu and by creating a hometown atmosphere. Other alternatives are Three Rivers Market, Earth Fair, and the French Market. These markets and restaurants are not in Market Square, but they do draw the organic crowd from in and around Knoxville. Since real food will be in Market Square, there won't be much small business competition. My main focus will have to be to get the word out since I'll be a virtual unknown. But Market Square proudly welcomes new businesses and there is a great support system there. Since real food is not a one-woman show, I'll need some help. I will need at least two people to take orders and handle the money, four people to make the food, and myself and one other person managing the restaurant. My sales forecast for the first year is $1,070,160. Of course, this doesn't include expenses, rent, or wages for employees. The rationale for that number comes from the hours that Real Food will be open. I plan to be open 11 to 8 for lunch and dinner, and with a 30-person capacity, I think from 11 to 1 would be our busiest time, bringing in about 270 people for lunch. From 2 to 4 would be considerably less at about 45 people. 5 to 8 would come back up to about 180 people for the dinner crowd. By finding a minimum price on the menu, I multiplied the traffic per day by $7.37, and then multiplied that number by 7 days, and then by 52 weeks. Startup financing for Real Food will include money for rent, any appliances not included in the building, utilities, tables and chairs, decorations and signs, cash registers, and the food. The rent for a 1,000 square foot building is $670 a month. I'll need $5,500 for a stove and a refrigerator. Utilities for the building will be $75 a month. Tables and chairs will be around $400. Decorations and signs will be around $200. Two cash registers will be $475 each, and I will need $1,663 for enough food for the first month. I will save as much as possible for real food, but I will also need help with financing. I plan to take advantage of social networking to create awareness for real food, in addition to raising money with the use of the site Kickstarter. I feel this approach will give the public the feeling that they are involved in the process. Like it's their baby as well as mine that we're bringing up out of an idea. I think by the time the doors open, Real Food will have already a community behind it and supporting it. In total, I need $10,202.